In this video, I will find the limit as x approaches 0, cosine of x to the power of 1 over sine x. So, when you're giving a limit question, the first thing you want to do is plug the value into x, whatever the x is approaching to, and maybe you will get the answer right away. If you get the answer right away, then you're done. But if you don't get the answer, then you have to do further work to get the answer. So, let's try this. So, if I put in cosine of 0 to the power of 1 over sine 0, because I will put 0 into x, then what is cosine of 0? So cosine of 0, if you put in the calculator, is equal to 1. So this is 1 to the power of 1 over what's sine 0? Sine 0 is 0. So now what you see is 1 over 0, like that's undefined, the degree of power is undefined. I guess you probably don't want to just like leave it like this. So let's do further work to get to the answer properly. Okay, so what we have to do next is, now what can you do? Now there's an exponent, 1 over sine x. But you don't want to leave the exponents on top like that. Then maybe you have to think about using the natural log property. So because we know that, let's say you have this, ln of a to the power of b, in the same as you can move the exponent to the front, b times ln of a. So you can utilize this property here. But in order to do this, you cannot just take the natural log of this limit. You cannot just take the natural log like ln of cosine of x to the power 1 over sine x, because you're changing the original limit if you do that. So in order for you to apply the natural log property, you have to let set this limit equal to something, set this function equal to something. So I will let y equals to cosine of x to the power of 1 over sine x. So let y equals to that. Then you can take the natural log of both sides. So ln of y is equal to ln of ln of cosine of x 1 over sine x. And don't forget, there's a limit there, so you have to keep the limit. Limit as x approaches 0, ln y equals to limit as x approaches 0, ln of cosine of x 1 over sine x. Okay, so now you can actually bring this exponent to the front. So the next thing is we write this as the right side will be just limit as x approaches 0, 1 over sine x times ln of cosine of x. Now 1 over sine x, I can actually rewrite this as ln of cosine of x over sine x. So let me rewrite this. So limit as x approaches 0, ln of y equals to limit as x approaches 0, ln of cosine of x over sine x. Now we just assume that cosine of x is positive greater than 0, because you know the ln of negative number is not really defined. Okay, so now what's gonna happen? Let's plug 0 into this limit now. You have ln of cosine of 0 divided by sine 0. Now what is cosine of 0? Cosine of 0 is equal to 1. Then what's ln of 1? Oh, I can write this just so that it's clear. So this is ln of 1, right? Sine 0 is just 0. Then what's ln of 1? Ln of 1 is 0. So at the end, you have 0 on the top and 0 at the bottom. So this is 0 over 0. It's indeterminate form. And of course, that's not the answer you're looking for either. So that means what you can do is you can actually apply the L'Hopital's rule to find the limit. And we're applying the L'Hopital's rule into this limit here. So let's do this. L'Hopital's rule. Okay, so let's ignore this side for now. We will come back to this. So let's just take on to the right side. Let's look at the right side for now. Ln of cosine of x divided by sine x. Okay. So next equals limit as x approaches 0. Take the derivative of the numerator divided by the derivative of the denominator. Okay, let me just write that better. Okay, well, we know that it's easy to find out the derivative of sine x, but what's the derivative of ln of cosine of x? Now let's just come here and take a look. Right. Derivative of ln of cosine of x. Again, assuming cosine of x is greater than 0. Okay, so as you can see, right, this is like the function inside another function. So it's like a function cosine of x inside the ln function. So you can use the chain rule. But first of all, let me just let g equals to this whole function, ln of cosine of x. Then in this case, I can let u equals to cosine of x. Then g is equal to ln of u, because I let u equal to cosine of x. So now I can take the derivative of u with respect to x. Well, that is negative sine x, okay? Because derivative of cosine of x is negative sine x. Then derivative of g with respect to u, right, on the second function here, this one. This is 1 over u. Now we know that. What do we say? U is equal to cosine of x, so I can rewrite this as 1 over cosine of x. Then what we're looking for here is dg over dx. So now dg over dx is equal to, now we can actually write that as dg over du times du over dx. Right, that's the chain rule, because du and du can cancel out. All you have left is just dg over dx. Okay, so what's dg over du? Well, we said that is equal to 1 over cosine of x, 1 over cosine of x times what's du over dx? Negative sine x. And now if we put this together, that is negative sine x over cosine of x is also the same as negative tangent of x. Okay. Now, limit as x approaches 0, negative tangent of x divided by derivative of sine x is cosine of x. Okay, now, can you put 0 into x now? Yes, you can, because I know that if you put 0 into cosine of x, basically it will be 1, right? So it's defined. But what is tangent of 0? Well, tangent of 0 is 0. Negative 0 is 0. So the top will be negative 0 and the bottom is 1. So the answer is 0. Okay, so what we are doing here is that this is equal to 0. This limit here is equal to 0. So this side here is equal to 0. Okay, let's take the whole thing. Limit as x approaches 0, ln of y equals to 0. So we will come here. All right, let's write it here. Limit as x approaches 0, ln of y is equal to 0. Okay, that's what we figure out. Well, we're not done yet, because we want to find out what y is. And we did say that. We said y equals to cosine of x to the power of 1 over sine x. So that's why we want to find out what y is. So how do you find out what y is? Well, we have ln of y. You want to isolate y. So just take e on both sides, right? So you can do this. E to the limit as x approaches 0. Ln of y is equal to e to the 0. All right, so you take the e of both sides. And then now take the limit to the front according to the limit property. So limit as x approaches 0, e to the ln of y is equal to e to the 0. Now e to the ln of y is just y. So we have limit as x approaches 0, y is equal to, now what's e to the 0? And it should be 1. So let's check it out. E to the 0 is 1. Okay, 1. Now, like I said before, y is cosine of x to the power of 1 over sine x. Because we're looking for the limit in terms of x. So where do we write this? Limit as x approaches 0. Cosine of x to the power of 1 over sine x is equal to 1. Are we done? Just take a look at the original question here. It is true that that's what we're looking for here. This one here. Limit as x approaches 0 cosine of x to the power of 1 over sine x. Over here. Limit as x approaches 0 cosine of x to the power of 1 over sine x. Okay, we get the answer. The answer to this limit is equal to 1. Hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.